So good afternoon everyone present here. Panel of judges, student managers, I, Debarun Chaudhary, and my partner,
Amal Jain of River Indrani,
is going to give a presentation on a topic which will come to know after watching the video. Slide of code.
So, how many of you just got excited after watching this video? Yeah, so many of you are just football fans, huh?
So let's move on to the contents.
So these are the case study on the Indian Super League. So my friend will continue up.
So these are the contents here, which will continue in the upcoming slides. So overview of ISL. Here, the ISL ones, the idea or concept of ISL was given on 21st October 2013. And then the first season of ISL was, the first season started on the 12th of October 2014. So the total revenue collected is 511.7 crore. It is sponsored by the IMG Reliance until 2018. Then they canceled their contract, Star Sports and AIFF, that is All India Football Federation. The deal between AIFF and IMG Reliance was of 700 crore. And the format is of league cum knockout, where each team plays with the other team for two matches, that is two-legged matches. And at the end of the phase of the leagues, there are knockouts, like semi-finals of two legs. The total number of teams in ISL is 10. And given is the ISL website.
So here is the mission. The main purpose of this Indian Super League was to enhance the brand value of the mission. Like most of us are just interested in cricket only. So for enhancing the interest of the public in football also, so this Indian Super League was organized. So the vision of this inauguration of this Indian Super League was to get the cup for the Indian country only in the 2026, which is going to be held in the Canada.
Canada, Mexico, and United States. Continue. So these are the objectives for the case study on ISL. To present an international quality domestic football competition. Earlier in India, the main competition of football was I-League, which didn't work out much. But when the concept of I-League came in 2013 and when it was implemented on 2014, the idea went on very well. And then till today, till 2018-19 season, it worked very well. And nowadays, ISL is well known all over the world very nicely.
Like I said, that most of us are just interested in cricket only. So, for the another objective of this is to enhance, engage hundreds and millions of passionate Indian football fans. So, by this activity, most of the people who just love football are just got an opportunity to show their talent and got another opportunity to be a part of an Indian, to represent India at the national level.
So, the next point is to encourage and facilitate the masses to start playing the sport. In India, there are lots and lots of talent. talents in rural areas especially, but they don't get that perfect infrastructure or the coaching. So through ISL, they get the proper platform where they can showcase their talent and can perform well in national level too.
Another objective is to produce a large pool of talented Indian players and to play for the Indian national team, like I said in my previous point only. So to get that proper talent for to represent our India at a national level or international level. So
the next point is to set new standards in sport administration, governance and marketing in India. Earlier, the standard of sports like football in India was not up to the mark. Like when I-League, they didn't have much recognition. But when ISL came, the football in India was much famous in all over the world. And the standard also grew. And marketing also increased at a very high speed.
Another point is to deliver value to all our stakeholders and partners and create demand for future investment. So the main thing which is important for the conducting of any program or any purpose is the investment or the capital which is required to carry out the process. So to believe in, to make a proper credibility to over the investors, this is the another objective of Indian Super League.
So these are the benefits of ISL. Helps in infrastructure development. Earlier in India, there are many football stadiums which are unused and were not utilized properly. But when ISL came and there were lots of funding of ISL, the stadiums grew at a very good rate. Like in Salt Lake Stadium, we have seen it was earlier the capacity was more than 1 lakh. But recently, they have decreased the capacity, but have increased the quality of seats and all and everything. So they have increased the infrastructure of the stadiums.
Next point is benefit to food, hostel and aviation industry, as many opportunities will be generated as many people will come to this country to get engaged in this program like Indian Super League. So because of which the food and hotel aviation will also get enhanced.
So the next one is provides employment opportunities to the people. So the people who work in the stadiums, like the workers, the laborers who work in on the field, off the field, the people who work for the health and all in the football, they've got employment opportunities. In local areas too, where they were unemployed, after the introduction of ISL, they've got a new way of living life and they've got employment.
New talent being sorted through grassroots program. Grassroots program is a program which is conducted by Indian Super League, in which children engaged from the age group of 6 to 14 are given the opportunity to show their talent, and from that those who show their talent at the best are selected for the future purpose.
So the next one is learning opportunity from foreign market players. So when the idea of ISL started, they had the idea like in each team there will be one single marquee player, that is a player that is well known all over the world. So the players like Roy Keane, Alessandro Del Piero, etc. were part of I-League. So through the help of these players, the local Indian players also got opportunity to get the exposure, and so they could learn more and more.
Another recognition of Indian football around the globe. This is another benefit of the Indian Super League.
So why is ISL better than I-League? Lack of proper infrastructure in I-League. The infrastructure of I-League, it was not adequate for football. The ground or the turf that they were using were artificial. So players used to get injured and all. So they weren't able to play properly.
Another is lack of promotion and proper media coverage. As for Indian Super League, many promotion strategies were adopted, but in for I-League, they do not use the proper promotion strategy.
Lack of quality players in I-League. Like I said already, that there were marquee players in ISL which were not available in I-League. So the quality was not as adequate as I-League.
Lack of adequate funding and investment. Second, another point is no recognition early as compared to Indian Super League. Average crowd is much more in Indian Super League. Another slide, please. Here's the slide.
So these are the sponsors for ISL 2018-19 season. The title sponsor is Hero, which all say Hero ISL. The associate sponsors are DHL, Xiaomi, Maruti Suzuki Arena. Then official partners are Bisleri, Britannia, Imperial Blue, Sonic, Apollo Tires, etc.
Another domestic competitors are Indian Super League, Indian Premier League, Premier Badminton League. As another As Indian Super League is only played in India only, so there are no different competitors in the this premium segment only. Please change the slide.
So these are the teams involved in ISL?
Change the slide.
That's all, please.
Thank you.